Hi everyone, welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another example of converting cylindrical coordinates to rectangular coordinates. The example that we're working with is the coordinate 2, 3 pi over 4, and 3. And these coordinates are cylindrical coordinates and we're going to change them into rectangular coordinates. So we're going to need this set of formulas here. X equals r cosine theta, y equals r sine theta, and z equals z. Keep in mind that our cylindrical coordinates are going to be, instead of with rectangular coordinates, we have x, y, and z. With cylindrical coordinates, we have r, theta, and z. So r is 2, theta is 3 pi over 4, and z is 3. So once we know that, all we have to do is plug in those numbers, and we'll get the formulas that we need to convert. So we're going to find the x-coordinate in our rectangular coordinate set, we'll use the formula r cosine theta, and so we're going to plug in 2 for r because, right, we said 2 was r, and then 3 pi over 4 is theta, so we plug in 3 pi over 4 for theta here. We're also going to get the equation y equals 2 sine of 3 pi over 4 because we're plugging in, again, 2 for r in this equation here, and 3 pi over 4 for theta. So that goes here inside of the sine function. And then we said that z was 3, pulling it from the coordinate here. So that goes into our third equation. Z is equal to 3. And with this equation, I know it looks a little funky, but we're always just going to take this third coordinate, and that's going to be our z. It's z in both cylindrical coordinates and in rectangular coordinates. So that just stays the same. It's 3. So now we just have to simplify the x and y equations, and the way that we're going to do that is by using the unit circle. So what we're going to do to find, to simplify this x equation, we're going to go ahead and leave the 2, but then we need to use the unit circle to find cosine of 3 pi over 4. So the way that we do that, we're looking for the angle on the unit circle, the area on the unit circle where the angle is equal to 3 pi over 4. So if we go to our unit circle and we follow along here until we get to this angle here, 3 pi over 4, we're looking for cosine of that angle. And cosine is going to be the x-coordinate at this angle here. So if we go look at the x-coordinate, we can see that it's negative the square root of 2 over 2. So that's what we're going to take for cosine of 3 pi over 4. So we take negative square root of 2 over 2, and we head back on over here. To our formula, and we plug in negative square root of 2 over 2 in for cosine of 3 pi over 4. So when we multiply that by 2, we have the 2 that cancels with the denominator, and we're just left with negative square root of 2 for x coordinate. We're going to do the same thing for y, and as you can see, we're looking again for the angle 3 pi over 4, but instead sine of that angle. So we go back to the unit circle, we look for the angle 3 pi over 4, and because we're looking for sine of the angle, we're going to be looking for the y-coordinate at that angle. And the y-coordinate, of course, you can see here is, instead of negative, it's positive square root of 2 over 2. So we take this y-coordinate here, square root of 2 over 2, and we head back over here to our formula, and we plug it in, square root of 2 over 2 for sine of 3 pi over 4. So that's what it replaces. Again, the 2's are going to cancel, and we'll be left with positive square root of 2. So that's what we found for x, y, and we already have z. So when we put those three together, we get our final answer, which is negative square root of 2 and 3. And those are the same rectangular coordinates as these cylindrical coordinates up here. So they're exactly equal, just these are the cylindrical coordinates, and these are the rectangular coordinates here. So I hope that helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!